Hare Krishna. The truth may be bitter, but it doesn't have to be told bitterly. Whenever someone is doing something wrong and we observe them doing that wrong thing, we have a natural tendency, even we could call it a natural temptation, to correct others. And if they react unfavorably to that correction, some people rationalize their correction, their corrective attitude, their fault-finding attitude by saying that the truth is bitter. Yes, sometimes the truth may be bitter, but everything that is bitter is not necessarily true. And even if what is being told is true and it is bitter, it doesn't have to be told bitterly. It can be told gently, politely, sensitively, encouragingly, empathically. Then it inspires people to change themselves for the better. We see this dynamic in the Bhagavad Gita in the 6th chapter. The whole chapter, Krishna is telling Arjuna about practicing the process of yoga, which centers on controlling the mind. And after hearing the whole process, Arjuna says, I can't do it. He says, Yoyam yogastvaya prokta samyena madhusudana etasyaham na pashyami chanchalatva sitim sthiram. I feel that what you're asking is not possible because the mind is restless. This 33rd verse and 34th verse, he says that chanchalam himana krishna pramathi balabhadrunam tasyaham nigraham manye vayoriva sudushkaram. The mind is so restless, wild, turbulent, it's impossible to control, like stopping a raging wind. What Arjuna is saying can be construed as a strongly worded protest against Krishna's instructions. Krishna is God, and he could have dismissed Arjuna's concern, saying that you just need to be more determined, you have to control your mind. But Krishna adopts a very empathic approach. The truth is that, yes, if we want to grow spiritually, in fact, even if we want to grow materially, we need some amount of capacity to control the mind. But Krishna understands Arjuna's concern and appreciates that concern and responds in a very empathic and encouraging way. In 6.35, he states, Asamshayam Mahabaho Manodur Nigraham Chalam Abhyasena tu Kaunteya Vairagyena cha Gruhyate. Asamshayam Mahabaho. Undoubtedly, O Arjuna, you are mighty armed and still Mano Durnigraham Chalam. Controlling the mind is very difficult. So many times when people are protesting or resenting what we are saying, what they need more than agreement is understanding. What oxygen is for the body, understanding is for the heart. If we don't feel understood, then we feel choked and we start protesting vehemently. So the first thing that Krishna does to Arjuna is, I understand. I understand it is difficult. And once Arjuna feels understood, then Krishna perseveres. He says, Abhyasena tu Kaunteya Vairagyena cha Gruhyate. By practice and by detachment, you can do it. So Krishna does not change the truth. Krishna does not say that, oh, the controlling the mind is so difficult, no need to control it. He says, yes, we have to control it. But by being understanding, he ensures that the bitter truth is not told bitterly, that it is told gently, encouragingly. So we can follow also Krishna's footsteps. And even when we have to tell the truth, which is bitter, we can tell it gently, not bitterly. Thank you. Hare Krishna.